Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the sixth part of our video, Democratic Resurgence. In this chapter, earlier we have done in detail the national emergency imposed in India on 25th of June 1975. And earlier we have done three ideologies about Deen Dayal Upadhyay, Ram Manohar Lohia and Jai Prakash Narayan and their ideologies. And this is a new topic which has been added to our syllabus and support material has been provided by CBSC. Now the question arises, what do you mean by the word democratic upsurges? Democratic upsurges ka meaning kya hai? It means that increasing participation of the citizens in the politics. From the very long time, for a period of 200 years, India was under the control of Britishers. And they have got independence in 1947. For the first time in 1951-52, after the independence, the elections were going to be held. So what were the expectations of common citizens from the political system? Logon ki kya kya demands thi political system se, and how these demands are to be fulfilled by the politics of the political system of the country. That is democratic upsurges. The people were full of zeal and enthusiasm to elect their own government, and they wanted to participate in the democratic politics of the country, and this is known as democratic upsurge, that increasing participation of the people in the democratic politics of the country. And we can divide based on this principle. The social scientists have divided the upsurges of democracy in the post-independence history of India in three upsurges. The first democratic upsurge, it starts in 1950s and ends in till 1970s. Till 1977, when Janata Party government was formed for the first time, up to that period, we call this first democratic upsurge. It was based on the participation of Indian adult voters to the democratic politics, both at the center and at the state. And afterwards, there was a very falsifying Western myth that democracy will not be a success in India. In the international level, it was said that Nehru will live to see the falsity of the experiment of democracy. Because in order to face the success in democracy, certain requirements are there. A nation should be modernized, urbanized, people should be educated, there should be access to media also, and there's successful holding of elections to both Lok Sabha and Legislative Assembly all over the states. So this principle, the international leaders, there was a myth that the people of India, they are uneducated. 50% of the people, they are living below poverty line. They are they are dying of hunger. The people are malnutrited. And so democracy is going to be a total failure in the country. As the Western myth says, a falsifying attitude, a falsifying aspect of Indian democracy, that the first elections in the country will be a very great failure in each and every respect. But opposite to that, opposite to this international view, our first election was a great success. People participated in the election, and they also, old people also participated with great enthusiasm. They came on the back of others. There were election mock drills were there. It happened a long time. It took a long time. Started in the October, November of 1951 and ended until February of 1952. And there was this sort of enthusiasm was seen in the whole of 1960s. 50s और 60s का जो दशक था उसमें लोगों के प्रति, लोगों के इन चुनावों के प्रति, क्योंकि वह एक ऐसी सरकार चुनना चाहते थे जो उन्हें वो सारे फंडामेंटल राइट्स प्रोवाइड करे जिनके लिए वो पिछले 200 सालों से लड़ रहे थे. बिकॉज आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस दे वांटेड टू मेक देयर ड्रीम्स ट्रू, सो दे They participated in this with great enthusiasm, and this was seen in 1960s also. And in the 70s, in the beginning of 70s till 1977, 1972 or 73 mein kuch Bihar aur Gujarat ke youth also, they started demanding their rights. They started against the falsifying promises, the false promises of the government, increasing unemployment, corruption, rising prices. They stood against all these things. So this was the democratic upsurge that came, and this was the main reason behind the imposition of the emergency in 1975. So first democratic upsurge hum 1950s se lekar 1977 tak dekhte hain, and the second democratic upsurge started during 1980s, because at that time Janata Party, they formed the government, and many of the parties were added in this, that which raised the question of the issue of disadvantaged section, lower caste section. SC ST ko to pehle hi constitution ke dwara reservation di gayi thi, but lower classes like other backward communities, they were demanding that the caste system should not be suppressive at that time. In 1977, when Janata Party government came in power, मंडल कमीशन बनाया गया, और मंडल कमीशन को बनाने का मेन पर्पस था टू लुक इनटू द बैकवर्डनेस ऑफ दीज कम्युनिटीज एंड टू सजेस्ट मेजर्स टू अपलिफ्ट देयर सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन. तो जब तक मंडल कमीशन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है आपके सिलेबस में की रिपोर्ट आती है, तब तक 1977 की जनता पार्टी की गवर्नमेंट बिल्कुल ही गिर जाती है. और उसके बाद 1989 में जब वीपी सिंह के नेशनल फ्रंट की गवर्नमेंट बनती है, इन दैट एरा ऑफ 1989 द रिकमेंडेशंस वर इंप्लीमेंटेड, द रिकमेंडेशंस मेड बाय मंडल कमीशन दे वर इंप्लीमेंटेड, एंड रिजर्वेशन टू अदर बैकवर्ड कम्युनिटीज वर गिवन इन जॉब्स एंड हायर एडुकेशन. बट एट दैट टाइम द opposition also started that there should be no reservation to other backward communities, because general caste, they had started opposing this issue of reservation being given to OBCs. So this theory is given about the second democratic upsurge ki theory. It has been given by Yogendra Yadav, who you know very well, that he is a contemporary पॉलिटिकल एनालिस्ट हैं. जब इलेक्टोरल रिजल्ट्स आते हैं तो उस समय एक्सपर्ट वो प्री पोल और पोस्ट पोल एनालिसिस पेश करते हैं. और इस डेमोक्रेटिक अपसर्ज में सेकंड में इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स मोर अकोमोडेटिव और एसेसिबल हो जाती है. सभी लोग अपनी कास्ट के बेस पर वोट मांगना स्टार्ट कर देते हैं. But although it has not made any major change in the lives of these classes, especially Dalits, but the participation of these classes into the political platform gave them opportunity to strengthen their self-respect, ensure empowerment in the democratic politics of the country. Beshak in reservations ke karan jo democratic demand logon dwara uthi hai ki OBCs ko bhi रिजर्वेशन मिलनी चाहिए, तो बेशक उनकी कंडीशन में इतना ज़्यादा इम्प्रूवमेंट नहीं आई है, लेकिन फिर भी दे हैव स्टार्टेड पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द पॉलिटिकल प्लेटफॉर्म्स ऑफ द कंट्री, एंड दे आर एबल टू स्ट्रेंथन देयर सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट. अगर आप उत्तर प्रदेश की बात करें तो मायावती की बहुजन समाज पार्टी और समाजवादी पार्टी, जिनके अभी लीडर अखिलेश यादव हैं, मुलायम सिंह यादव पहले थे, तो इन दोनों पार्टीज ने शुरू से ही अपने एस्टेब्लिशमेंट के टाइम से ही दलित्स और ओबीसीज लोअर सेक्शंस के लिए काम करना शुरू कर दिया है और शुरू किया है, और देयर मेन एजेंडा इज फॉर डिमांडिंग द वेलफेयर ऑफ दीज लोअर क्लासेस. for demanding the reservation of these classes. Third democratic upsurge, it came in the era of 1990s. 1990s mein liberalization, privatization and globalization policy has been adopted by the Narasimha Rao government, and in this era it is emergence of competitive market society that encompasses all important sectors of economy, society and political. Har field mein there should be competitive, quality should be best at national level and at international level. Jab privatization ho gaya to state ne third democratic upsurge लाने के लिए सबसे ज़्यादा काम एलपीजी की पॉलिसी ने किया. इस एरा को 1990 में लॉन्च किया गया था और इस एरा में द कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस इन एवरी सेक्टर ऑफ इकोनॉमी, सोसाइटी एंड पॉलिटी दैट हेल्प्स इन पेविंग द वे टू थर्ड डेमोक्रेटिक अपसर्ज. इट रिप्रेजेंट्स अ डेमोक्रेटिक अ कॉम्पिटिटिव इलेक्टोरल मार्केट, क्योंकि अगर आपने नेशनल लेवल और इंटरनेशनल लेवल पर एग्जिस्ट करना है तो द प्रिंसिपल विल नॉट बी सर्वाइवल ऑफ द बेस्ट बट द सर्वाइवल ऑफ द एबलेस्ट. वन हैज़ टू प्रूव एट एवरी लेवल, बिजनेस हैज़ टू बी इम्प्रूव. अगर किसी ने नेशनल और इंटरनेशनल या फिर रीजनल लेवल पर सेट होना है, चाहे आप जॉब सेक्टर में हो चाहे आप business sector mein ho, in that they have to provide the ablest facilities to the people. It also underlines that India's electoral market from state to market, state ab market ki taraf ja raha hai, government governance kar rahi hai, state is no more a controller, he is a facilitator. State has to facilitate economic growth. For example, if one has to improve the business of himself or herself, there are certain facilities to be provided by the state, like he needs transport facilities, cheaper electricity facilities, he needs proper paperwork of licensing and all. So state has to provide all the facilitate, has to become a facilitator, and state has to facilitate economic growth, and government has to facilitate the individual so that he can compete with the international market. And he can, states का main काम हो जाता है कि वो एक व्यक्ति को, एक individual को skill provide करे ताकि वो international level पर compete करने के capable हो सके. So that citizens can survive in the competitive market. So democratic upsurge में youth की participation को एक बहुत बड़ा role दिया गया है. Significant chunk of Indian society have emerged the real game changers in the view. Both the development and the governance of India's contemporary democratic politics has been seen. If you see the election manifesto of NDA government, BJP jo hai, pehle election manifesto mein inka main mudda Ram Mandir issue hua karta tha. But now they have come up from caste politics to the politics of development. In the same way, they in 2009 they have given the slogan of 2019 they have given the slogan of Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas. Instead of sticking to one slogan, one issue, one agenda, they have promoted the development of all in the governance of the of India's government. गवर्नमेंट एक स्टेट जो है वो फैसिलिटेटर का काम करेगा और जिसमें कि यूथ की पूरी पार्टिसिपेशन होगी और साथ में सिटीजन्स, इट द स्टेट विल फैसिलिटेट अ सिटीजन टू सर्वाइव इन द कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट एज एनविसेज्ड बाय लिबरलाइजेशन, प्राइवेटाइजेशन एंड ग्लोबलाइजेशन. क्योंकि एलपीजी में कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट होती है, चाहे वो मार्केट नेशनल लेवल पर हो, इंटरनेशनल लेवल पर हो, हर एक व्यक्ति को वहाँ पर टिकने का, तभी तक वो टिक सकता है जब तक वो बेस्ट सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करे. एंड टू फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ऑल, फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग स्किल्स टू ऑल, द गवर्नमेंट विल स्टार्ट वर्किंग. सो दिस वाज ऑल विद द थर्ड डेमोक्रेटिक अपसर्ज एंड दिस इज till now also. So these were the three democratic upsurges. Thank you. Have a nice day.